So I've been a football fan since I was a kid. And even though I played just very little, yes, this is a embarrassing picture of me. I never really was any good, obviously. Look at that guy. He's not going to be playing a lot of football. So there's an old saying that those who can't coach. And I do. I'm a football coach. I am a coach doc. That's the nickname I have. I have a PhD that's completely different video. But that's who I've been. I've been coach doc for a long time. And I love it. So I've had a lot of influences on how I coach. First off, Bill Walsh, the great coach in the 80s for the 49ers.
Tell Freddie to split about 6 or 7 yards on this thing, and then get his up that field, and you watch that safety, okay? Okay. Oh. Oh. What? Yeah, you did the best you could. That's a good job. So if it's not there, you just time throw it.
If I had fell, though, I had him.
He really influenced how I like to throw the ball, how we do the passing game.
Dwight is in here sliding back out.
And of course, the run game is heavily based on Mike Shanahan.
I'd like to get something where if I can run Shannon down the gut, and then I can throw it out outside. But I can't do anything on Omaha with those safeties.
And what he did in Denver, and what his coaches continue to do to this day with his zone run scheme. Because clearly, that was effective.
I love you. Oh, great job. Oh.
So defensively, I really patterned what I like to do after a guy named Buddy Ryan, who is one of the greatest defensive minds of all time.
Buddy Ryan is one of the most fascinating people in NFL history. He brought a tough, entertaining, and extremely aggressive defensive style of football to whatever team he coached. And for those who were part of the opposition, Buddy Ryan was someone that could be easily hated on. Ryan was known for being the architect of the 1985 Bears, known for creating one of the best and intimidating defenses in Philadelphia, and known for punching the Oilers offensive coordinator while being the defensive coordinator in Houston.
One of his most famous quotes is, "The receiver isn't open if the quarterback can't get him the ball." And I have taken that everywhere I've gone, every defense I've coached, I've pushed that. So I started off coaching in Parks and Rec, Little League, basically football. Been a couple years there, about 3 years. Won a championship there. Then I went up to the high school. I was the JV head coach for the local team for several years. And I absolutely loved it. It was so great working with kids, working with teenagers. And this is a buddy of mine, Coach Joe. Him and I have coached for like 5-6 years together. One of my best friends. And I love it. I mean, I get into it when I coach. I mean, this is after a touchdown. This is one of many pictures of me jumping up and down with the kids, you know, celebrating after a win. You know, did a lot of that. And I'm kind of fiery. That's me right there in the middle yelling. This was after a huge win right here against our rival. So I do want to show you, just to show you how excited I get. Here's a clip of one of our... I can't remember when this game was. It was a long time ago. But, so watch the skinny white dude at the bottom in the khaki pants. He just makes a fool of himself. I could say this was the only clip of that, but the truth of the matter is there's a lot of those. I love it. I just love it. So recently I left the high school. The grind is really hard to go in every single day. And with work, it really became difficult. So I went back down to the Parks and Rec level. Didn't really enjoy it as much, to be honest. There's so much more you can do with teens. There's so much more you can do with kids who are older. A lot of the kids I coached this year had never played before. There was so much teaching and so much dumbing down of everything we had to do so that they would understand it. I don't think it was a good fit going back to Parks and Rec. So there you go. I will tell you this. Every single season, I've been head coach a long time. Every year I tell my team the same thing. That I coached them because I couldn't coach my own son. That I could never lament with him after a loss and celebrate with him after a victory. I could never teach him to throw a spiral or how to make a good tackle. And I coached them because I couldn't coach you. And that's no BS. That's the truth. From the very beginning, the day I first became a coach, my first speech to the team was that I'm here with you because I couldn't do it for my own son. And I wanted them to learn that to not make the same mistakes I did. And I'm very open with being an alcoholic and struggling with that, overcoming it, you know, day to day. I coach because I love the game and because I can't coach you. I never got the chance. And that's my own fault. And I try and teach those kids to not make the same mistake I did. There you go, Coach Doc. I love you, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.